welcome to the new video about fugue improvisation. Today we are going to work on some theme that doesn't quite follow totally our usual pattern, but which is still not too far from our habits. Our theme today will start with a sixth jump and then go down stepwise as follows. Since the first and last notes of the theme are the same, there are two possibilities for the second cue. It could be higher than the first, or we could make a bridge. As we have already seen in the former video, fugues with a tenor clause usually begin with low voices. Many of them have a more vocal stile antico style, which is a kind of Baroque imitation of Renaissance polyphony. When the second voice enters, you will notice that the sixth jump at the beginning is very elegant. The comus makes AF, both notes fitting well with the last D of our theme, creating a full D minor chord. Therefore, the modulation to the dominant comes a little later, only in the second measure of the theme. We have different possibilities how to proceed. We could make a simple soprano clause, which is the syncopated voice. So, that's one possibility. Now we could replace the soprano clause by a deceptive cadence. We could also create another counterpoint. It's especially nice if the last note of the dux is slurred to the next bar, creating a dissonance, like that. All those examples which have no leading tone would allow a dux to enter on the last note of the comus. That dux could be above or below. Now let's see how a low voice could enter. So we have the ending of the comus and the bass is entering directly. We could add a counterpoint to the bass entrance. If you were paying attention, you would have noticed an unprepared fourth. Here it is. However, it's acceptable here because it's in a standard formula called cadenza doppia. The cadenza doppia is a formula where one voice is having a leading tone, a syncopation, and another leading tone. So, we have it here in the alto. The syncopation may be dissonant even at the beginning, as it's the case here. We could do something different without that unprepared dissonance. For instance, this. There's a lot to be said about that as well. First, the theme in the bass contains a potential Phrygian cadence. This is indeed a kind of tenor clause. However, the semitone is in the tenor clause and not in the soprano clause. So here you have the semitone, and here you have no semitone. Instead of and in the example I presented, we have the Phrygian cadence. Later, I decided to do some sixth parallels in the two upper voices. Such thirds or sixths can be a good solution for many counterpoint situations. Bach uses them often in the fugue BWY 853 as thirds and as sixths. See, for example, bar 8 of the same fugue, where it also fills a syncopation in the bass. So you have here the syncopation. And in the upper voices. Same phenomenon, syncopation in the bass, sixth in the upper voices during the syncopation. It's bar 12 of the same fugue. Let's go back to our fugue. If we want to make a fourth voice, we could make a tenor enter. Let's keep this idea for the counterpoint between tenor and bass. First of all, let's look at the cadence. There should be a soprano clause. It could be in two ways. First way, second possibility, both solutions are with a cadenza doppia, however, one is double as fast as the other one. To understand and complete what we didn't complete for the fourth entrance, we should use basso continuo. So, here we have just the D minor chord, this is not difficult. But here we can do a second, fourth, and sixth chord. It could also be in three voices. Here is one possibility for the beginning of the fugue, starting with an alto, a soprano, a bass, and a tenor as last entry. Here is another possibility, which starts with the bass. to finish, I will improvise a fugue on this theme.